got up early, drove around, and there's waves washing up over the road. And I was just like, oh. At that moment, I go, I'm not getting away. We never knew what we were doing from the get-go. That was the biggest thing, and that's what made it the most fun too. So it was like just a learning curve the whole way through it.
Mother, oh, she's gone. We lost her in the fog. The moment took her well. And now she's gone forever. She's lost in the arms of the ocean. Clasp you to my chest. Protect you from the wind. And now we've got you, we won't let go. We've never been apart, we've never been alone.
Through your hair, let's see.
apart. The moment took her a while, and now she's gone forever. She's lost in the arms of the ocean.
Anywhere, like I feel like I could live anywhere and still be able to. Well, right now I still have the freedom to travel wherever I want and go surf wherever I want. So I don't really find myself needing to base myself anywhere. That's probably the best thing to describe a professional bodyboarder at this day and age. everyone's doing bigger airs and guys are coming up with new moves starting to come up with new moves. So those guys are probably my biggest influence. But as far as like bodyboarders as influencing me, I'd say it's nothing compared to the way surfers have influenced me. Like I'd look at them and just go, I want to ride like that.
Sky is red, clouds are gray, and copper moon. One day I tell you.
Competitively, I reckon I haven't caught up to speed of what the judges want to see. Just because, like, I think, yeah, I'll probably surf on more of my own terms, and I like what I deem to be good surfing is not what they think is good surfing. So I'll probably struggle with that, and I've probably fought that through my whole competitive career for sure, and tried to argue with, but at the end of the day you're playing to competitive contest rules and what they want to see, so you're only going to come undone trying to go against what they want to see.
Is it too much sacrifice for you to bear?
If you want, like... I don't throw myself into anything, but there's moments where I enjoy surfing big waves. Like there's, when I'm out there, when it's big, most of the time I'm pretty calculated, and there's other times where I just want to attack anything. It doesn't matter what size, how shallow it is. Like I want it so bad, and I don't know where that's come from. Maybe I've just grown into it, but those early days of getting into bigger waves, I was just didn't want a bar of it. And like, I'm happy with that now, but back then it was just the worst experience. Like, everyone thinks you're going to do so well, and I've got Mike there in your corner giving you boards, giving you tips, and I was just like, I don't want to hear your tips. They don't mean anything to me. They're stupid.
Are launching.